Hi everyone, it's Spirituality, and today's video is gonna be a little bit different. A lot of you guys have been asking me if I can show you how to do witchcraft on the go, traveling and whatnot. And I travel almost every weekend to go visit my boyfriend who lives 3 hours away from me. But this weekend we're taking a little mini vacation. We're staying in a hotel a couple hours away from us. And we're going to be seeing my favorite band in concert. So I thought that this would be a fun opportunity to do like a vlog style video, but also, you know, like I said, show you guys some travel witchcraft, what you can do when you're on the go to keep the magic up, right? So, and I'll also probably be showing some footage of the concert and just fun things like that too. And there'll also be some good broom closet witch tips in this video as well. So we're doing a bunch of things, but I'm super excited and I think you guys will like that. So with all that being said, here's the tea. So when you're on the go, something that I recommend is having something witchy in your car. This could be having a spell jar in your glove compartment or your cup holder or even on a string around your rear view mirror. But if you're in the broom closet and can't have anything that looks obviously witchy in your car, color magic can play a huge part. So for example, the color black is great for protection. You could even draw a sigil on the back of this and make it really small so that no one will see. Or even, like I said, just black for protection or using other colors and their associations. I absolutely recommend having something in your car if you're someone who drives a lot, travels a lot. And this is also just good in day-to-day magic. Even if you only have a 5-minute commute to work, it's still good to have something in your car. I also really quick wanted to add another way that you can do color magic, whether you're in the closet or on the go, is through your clothes or your fingernails. These are really bad stick-on nails from Spirit Halloween. And I mostly got them because they match the outfit that I plan on wearing to the concert tomorrow. And I will probably take them off as soon as the concert is finished because I'm seeing Motionless in White. Like, you gotta go all out with the attire, as you will see later in this video. But I just thought that that was another good witchy tip that I would add in here too. And now I'll show you guys what I'm gonna pack. So one thing that I do is that I have pieces of jewelry dedicated to each of my deities and or entities. Some of them look really witchy, like Lilith's necklace has her sigil on it, so that looks really witchy. Ashura's necklace is a pentagram, but like with Yeshua, I have a lot of bracelets that just have like a little cross or a little Bible verse on them, and those are societally, is that the word? Socially acceptable. But that's something that I would recommend for traveling or closeted witches, is dedicating jewelry to your deities. So I obviously have a lot of crystals, but I'm not bringing a ton of them with me. I'm bringing my hematite ring, which I don't wear very often because you're not supposed to wear those like all the time, but wearing them every now and then is fine. My black tourmaline for protection, amethyst so that I sleep okay in the hotel room, and rose quartz because I'm gonna be with my boyfriend. Something else that you can do for being witchy on the go is getting an essential oil roll-on like this, especially if it has a certain intent assigned to it. You can use it to roll on your sigils or anything like that. I'm gonna be wearing a lot of makeup to the concert tomorrow, so I'll try to remember to vlog that part to show you guys how you can do sigils with makeup. That helps when you're on the road, and it also helps if you're in the broom closet. But looking around, I think this is the last thing from my altar that I plan on taking with me. So let's hit the road. Now, it is about a 2.5-hour drive and I struggle with fatigue. So to make sure that I'm nice and energized on the road, I'm trying to cut back on my caffeine a little bit. I'm gonna chow down one of my natural Shilajit honey sticks. If you're interested in getting some natural Shilajit for yourself, click the link in the description. I almost said click the link in my bio. Click the link in the description and use code T10 at checkout to get 10% off your order. I made it to the hotel room. My boyfriend just got off work, so he's on his way, but I'm gonna be by myself for a couple hours. So I think I'm gonna meditate with my crystals, and then afterwards I'll put them in my pocket or on the nightstand tonight, or, you know, just whatever I feel is appropriate. And then, you know, when we go out and about in public, I'll use my little roll-on stick to roll on some protection sigils or, you know, whatever intent I'm feeling at the time. And yeah, if we do anything interesting, I'll be sure to vlog it. Now, something else that you want to consider is cleansing, because it's a hotel room. How many people have stayed here before, right? Now, because it's a hotel room, it's not like you can use incense or candles to smoke cleanse or anything like that. So when you're in a space like this, I definitely recommend sound cleansing, even if it's just putting on some relaxing music with the intent of it cleansing your space, clapping your hands, saying an incantation, you know, something along the lines of, if you're not a positive energy, then don't be here. You know what I mean. I tried to do some readings and Microsoft Word just absolutely would not load. But my boyfriend is here, so I think we're just gonna relax and eat candy and watch Ancient Aliens. So something witchy that you can do with your makeup is put sigils on your face with your moisturizer, concealer, foundation, whatever. I'm just kind of drawing on my sigil with my finger with my moisturizer, and then I rub it in. And I do that with my foundation and some other things as well. And this was the final look, and I felt amazing. I have returned from the concert, and I want to tell you some other quick things that I realized that you could do
as you're traveling and doing witchcraft, or if you are in the closet. So when you're washing, you know, makeup off, or just washing your face at the end of the day, you know, that can be used as like a form of cleansing yourself, or you can do that in the shower, like self-cleansing mini ritual. You can say a quick blessing over your food, even if it's just in your head, silently to yourself. That's something that you can do. And then finally, you can do what I'm about to do, which is put intentions in your naps. So say a quick affirmation that I'm gonna take this nap and it's gonna rejuvenate me and heal me and make me feel great, because I am suffering from what is known in the metal community as bangover, in which you headbang so much that you are sore the next morning. So I'm gonna take a nap and put some intention in my naps. I'm sorry this vlog wasn't more interesting. It was my first vlog. I'll try to do more in the future that are a little bit more in depth. Trying new things. But thank you so much for watching this, and I'll see you guys next time. Blessed be.